For today's video, I couldn't find more than a few pictures of the defendant and none of the victims in this case. The story itself is horrible, however, and still needs to be shared. Let's jump in. In February 2002, Timothy and Emma Adams lived in an apartment in Houston with their 18-month-old son, Tim, and Andrew, who's Emma's 13-year-old son from a previous relationship. On Friday, February 15th, Emma decided to move out after discovering that her husband was keeping a gun in the apartment. She took her children with her and moved in with her friend, Karen Farr. That Saturday, Emma went to the apartment with a police officer and retrieved some of her things. On Sunday, she spoke with Adams on the phone and informed him she was moving out. He agreed and said that she could return on Tuesday and get more of her belongings, and he would not be there. After doing so, she told Adams that she needed to make one more trip for her remaining belongings. He told her she could return on Wednesday and agreed that he would once again not be there. Emma then made arrangements with Andrew to meet him at the apartment after school on Wednesday the 20th. Andrew arrived at the apartment as planned. Adams then came up behind him, pointed a gun at him, and said, "I should shoot you now." He ordered Andrew to sit on the floor and accused him of stealing videotapes from him. Adams angrily asked Andrew why his wife was doing this to him and told him she was going to pay. As they waited together for Emma to arrive, Adams wrote a note to her and read it aloud to Andrew. The message read, quote, "Look what you and your selfish pride did. You thought I was playing. Now you see I wasn't. Don't ever tell me what I can't do with my own child. You wish you had let me spend time alone with my child now. You wish you had been calling our son Tim Jr. now. You wish you had not called me those names now. You wish you had washed my clothes and fixed me something to eat now." End quote. Eventually, Emma returned with Tim. When she entered the apartment, she saw Andrew sitting on the floor and saw Adams with a gun in his hand. She put Tim down on the floor and asked what was going on. Tim ran over to Adams, and he picked him up with one arm while holding the gun in the other. He told Emma that Andrew had confessed to stealing from him and yelled at Andrew to tell her the truth. Emma asked Adams why he picked up the baby. In response, he yelled at her and pointed the gun. Emma then picked up the phone and called 911. Timothy yelled at Emma to put down the phone, but she continued to talk with the 911 operator. Adams then pointed the gun at her. Andrew attempted to jump in front of the weapon aimed at his mom, but Adams had already fired. Luckily, the bullet went through Emma's shirt and barely grazed her back. She and Andrew ran for the door and escaped. A couple of minutes later, Andrew returned and pounded on the door, begging Adams to hand over Tim. Adams did not answer the door. Police officers, including a SWAT team, were sent to the apartment complex. Witnesses saw Adams looking out of the apartment window holding baby Tim with a gun to his head. One witness saw Adams hit Tim on the back of the head with the butt of the gun. Adams had numerous telephone conversations with friends, relatives, co-workers, and police officers during the standoff. He told one police officer that he wasn't giving himself up and had already shot himself in the stomach. He said he would kill himself if anyone tried to enter the apartment. He told another officer he would shoot anyone who came through the door. Emma's friend called when she saw the standoff on television. Adams told her he was going to make Emma hurt the rest of her days on Earth like she made him suffer. He told her he had shot Tim twice in the chest and shot himself in the stomach. After shooting Tim, Adams continued his note to Emma on a second page. Quote, "You will never forget this, will you, bitch? You wish you had just been a wife now, don't you? You should have never tried to take my son away from me. I told you, bitch. I hate you too. You should have loved your husband, bitch." End quote. Adams ultimately surrendered after talking to a member of the Houston Police hostage negotiation team. The standoff lasted about 2.5 hours in total. When police entered the apartment, they found Tim dead on the floor. He died from 2 bullet wounds in his chest. The medical examiner testified that the gun's muzzle was touching the victim's skin when it was fired. Adams later testified that he shot Tim a second time because he did not die after the first shot. In a lengthy recorded confession, Adams said Emma had mentally abused him. He said she was mean and evil and that, quote, "Whatever I try to give my son, do for him, and be there for him, she would not let him have it," end quote. Citing an example, he said a woman at work gave Tim a chair. Emma put toys in the chair so that Tim could not sit in it, quote, "just basically to be mean so he couldn't have the gift I gave him," end quote. She untruthfully told others he didn't give her money for diapers and food, which, quote, was just her mean, evil way of being mean to me, end quote. Adams also stated that she knew Andrew was stealing from him, but she called him a liar when he confronted her about it. Quote, my wife was hurting me. She was keeping him away from me. I was going to take him out, and me too. She was not going to get a chance to hurt me or my son anymore. She wasn't going to keep us apart. She wasn't going to teach him not to love me. And me, I couldn't love him. End quote. After firing the first shot at Emma, he said that he intended to fire the gun again, but it jammed, giving her time to escape. His other complaints included that she did not open his Mother's Day card and made up an excuse not to go out with him on Mother's Day. She also did not buy him a birthday present or sing happy birthday to him. Emma Adams testified that her husband was suspicious and jealous and accused her of seeing other men. He told her that he had followed her to see if she was meeting anyone. He told her that he was hoping to catch her with another man so he could kill both of them right then and there. Adams also listened in on a phone conversation between Emma and a male co-worker. After the phone call, he screamed at her and beat her with his fists. Emma also testified that Adams had stated if she ever left him, she would never see Tim again. Emma's friend Karen testified that Emma and the children often came to her house to eat because Emma said there was no food at home. She testified that Adams told her about two movies he had watched about a man who murdered his wife and did not get caught. Adams' co-workers also testified that he was an excellent employee and a proud father. They were shocked to hear of the charges against him. Adams had no previous criminal record. A jury convicted Timothy Adams of capital murder in March 2003 and sentenced him to death. Timothy Wayne Adams was executed by lethal injection on February 22, 2011 in Huntsville, Texas. He was pronounced dead at 6:31 p.m. Adams' mother, brother, and sister attended his execution. He made no last statement, but he mouthed some words to his family before the lethal drugs were administered. He did not look at the other witness room, from which Emma Adams and her family were watching. He was 42 years old.